I'm Rebecca Vernon and this is my YouTube channel. Thank you for dropping by. So today we thought we would do dresses for Valentine's Day. Now, in my opinion, it doesn't matter whether you're going out or staying in, but you always want to look nice on Valentine's night if you're doing a nice meal at home or you're going out. I'm actually going to a Valentine's dance this year, which I tend to do most years actually, so that will be on the Saturday before. So yes, I'm looking for something for that, and everybody really dresses in red, but I think actually it's quite nice to dress in pink because I think pink is also a colour of love. So yeah, I thought I would start off in one of the dresses. Now this dress is actually a next dress. It's in the sale. And I've ordered it actually in an 18 and a 20 because I had a feeling it might be quite skimpy on the sizing. Now, if you can see, the underlayer here is sort of pleating a bit funny, and then the overlayer feels quite tight. The underlayer is stretchy and the overlayer is not. And that's probably the issue with it. It actually is better on me than I thought it was going to be, and it's got this bit of swirliness around here, which is great, and it is like the new trend. Last year it was in a lot of with a lot of occasion dresses for weddings. It's actually only £17 this dress because it's been reduced. So let's just see if it makes a difference if I put the next size on. Size is only a number, and sometimes some dresses, when they're cut for the price, they're also cut with the fabric being a little skimpy. So let's try the other size. Okay, so this is the next size up. So this is actually a 20. Now, I haven't worn a 20 ever, but I think it's due to the dress. Sometimes you can just do with a little tiny bit more ease in a dress. And let me share something with you. I used to work in the clothing industry. I used to work for a company that made for Marks and Spencers. So years ago, I'm going back a long time ago now, when I was young, they have what are called sizing differentials. So years ago, it only used to be half an inch difference between the cut on the dresses. So all the sizes were very, very accurate. Now you could go in a shop, pick up the same dress, three size 18s, 12s, whatever you are, and you could measure them and they would all be different. Absolutely all be different. The length would slightly be different. The cut would slightly be different on the bust. It depends on who's sewn it. So, yeah, so don't think about the sizing in the dress too much, because this could be only a quarter of an inch bigger than the other one that was an 18. Or it could be an inch and a half. You just don't know. So sometimes when you order a dress and you think, oh, that's a little bit tight, don't just order it in this next size up. Order it in the same size again. You might find that that actually is the one that's the perfect fit, because it might actually be half an inch or an inch bigger, not and you might not actually need that bigger size. So this is less clingy on the underslip now, and that I think is not giving as much. No, I think it is still doing it there. Still doing it there. Yeah, sure it is. Anyway, it's a pretty dress. For £17, I suppose I'm being a little bit fussy, that you get this sort of drapiness here and you can see the pleats underneath. Anyway, yeah, I'm feeling quite happy in it. And I suppose if I was dancing in it and if I was sat down having a meal, would you see that bit there? No, probably not. It's just the movement of the dress. I'm just very fussy. So yeah, £17, pink wonder. Yeah, liking that. Obviously I would need a strapless bra underneath, but I haven't dug that out yet. So let's try something else. I think it's £37. What I might always go to is looking clearance, looking the sales. There's lots of things out there. So this is a really nice dress if you're going to a dance, or some sort of dinner dance. Maybe you've got something coming up with friends, husband, whatever, charity do. It's got a little bit of the sticky stuff there to hold it up. I feel it is a little bit big on me, this dress. It fits nicely on the waist, but amazingly, it feels a bit big up here, which is not normal. Then again, I have not got a padded bra on today. And possibly if I had a strapless bra on, or I would probably wear a body underneath this, so everything would be pushed up a bit more. Maybe I need to get them in the right place. That's probably a bit better. You don't have to wear the shoulders down there. You could actually wear them up on the top if you wanted to. Yeah, you could wear them like that. So it creates more of a sweetheart neck. It's got a split right from the up into the thigh, and it's to the floor. So this is a stretchy velvet, and I think it came in at £37. So it's got a bit of a ruching on the bottom to give you a nice derriere. I'm thinking that's a really nice shape, actually. I'm liking this dress. Lovely, nice necklace. Nice little necklace, or just keep it simple with something like I'm wearing. You could just have a little bracelet on there. I wouldn't want my big watch on there, obviously. I think that's a really nice dress. I'm liking this. Just, it's not suitable for where I'm going. So let's try the next dress on. This one is actually a velvet dress. Now, it has a bow tie here at the back, which I've now tied my hair in. So that's a really nice detail on it. I probably would want to wear my hair up on this because it's got a really, really pretty back to it. Yeah, you definitely want to wear your hair up. It feels as if, dare I say it, that you are the Valentine's parcel, because it's got a ribbon tying it up at the back. I'm feeling like that's the sort of vibe it's giving off. No need for a present, already wrapped. There we go, pop the hair up. It's got a really nice sleeve. It's actually a stretchy velour-y velvet. It's got a really nice little sleeve on it, really nice back, split to the on the thigh there. Thinking that's a really, really nice dress. Actually, I'm loving that. Price wise, oh my goodness, why can I not see the price? Why have I not looked at what the make was? Sequiny dress, no, don't have a clue. It's got to be in the, I think that's got to be about £34. Don't even know what the make was, to be honest. But when I take it off, I'll tell you on the next dress. So keep watching. Okay, so this is the next dress. So the last one was actually a Love and Roses dress. So that was the one that was £37. I don't know what the price was of that other one. That was a Lipsy dress. So that must be the one that I've got the wrong price on. The Lipsy dress. The Lipsy dress that I tried, which was the velvet one, this one. That is £46. But I don't think that's bad for a dress. So this one is actually Simply B. And it's a dotty chiffon. Liking this. This is that sort of, it's almost like fluffy. Which, yeah, okay, so that is 1950. So I think this is quite a nice dress. This could just take you for drinks, could take you for a nice meal out. Not something necessarily too posh, but you could equally dress it up more posh if you wish to. So you could put a little pair of strappy sandals on, or you could just easily wear this with a pair of really cute trainers. Liking this because it's got a V-neck, but it's not too deep. You feel very comfortable in it. The arms are nice. We've got elastic round the sleeve, which is always good. And I don't think there's no fasten. It just pops on over your head. It's got a little frill there. So yeah, I'm liking that. It's got elastic here, which is very, very comfortable. So for 1950, I don't think that's a bad one at all. I think I'm liking this. Really nice. So what colour do you think you should wear for Valentine's Day, pink or red? Anyway, I'm a bit of a pink and red girl, to be fair. Which colour will I go for? I do not know. So this could have been part one